Okay, so this last Goofy Goober token that I accidentally unlocked and that we figured out in between episodes is really stupid, and I don't know how we both missed it, because it's really freaking obvious, kind of. The wall's differently colored and everything. Welcome back to SpongeBob SquarePants Battle! The movie video game version.
Bungie quickly before... Okay, I died, but... Bungie quickly before everything kills you!
Yeah, that's pretty much... That's pretty good description of what's going on right now. Don't shoot. No, don't shoot. You're gonna kill me! I only have one life left! Why? These stupid laser dudes.
Okay, so
missiles.
I do have to put out a generalized reminder that a few episodes ago, I don't remember if Chris remembers this, he might regret this decision now that he's played the other game, but we did put out a thing saying if Chris does win, which, let's face it, even though I'm losing right now, isn't going to happen because he's never going to win, but say in the chance that he does, right, what game we're going to do is the tiebreaker, and the options are between Creature from the Krusty Krab and Revenge of the Flying Dutchman. But the thing you have to remember is Revenge of the Flying Dutchman is more similar to these games in structure, but Creature from the Krusty Krab is more similar to these games mechanically in terms of like controls and stuff sometimes, not all the time, but closer than Revenge of the Flying Dutchman anyway. Make your choice. You could do that in this episode or whatever episode we said before. And then we will figure it out. Because I have a PS3 now, I can play all the games, and I have all of the SpongeBob games here with me, so no problems with either.
You have a million SpongeBob games.
Yeah, I actually do. I have, like, the GBA ones, too, and I have Lights, Camera, Pants, and The Accursed, that I didn't bring with me to college, actually, but I have Atlantis SquarePantis on PS2, which is the worst game I think I've ever played, honestly.
That's great.
It's just so utterly bad. I wish that upon no one. I mean, it's probably SpongeBob Hero Pants is worse, but like, that's like a game that like you look at and you're like, this is bad. Where Atlantis SquarePants, if you look at it and you're like, oh, it might be good. It's
and
not.
Horrible. Okay. Quickly before I leave this level, this wall was not broken before. I walked up to it and one of those missile guys blew it up in between episodes and I couldn't, you know, fix it. So
I fixed it.
Alright, time to do the final boss. Turn the tables on Plankton. I'm sorry, Matt.
Oh, no. But I need to drive faster. Drive faster. Of course. Let's just... Stupid Plankton statue being in the way. Made me fail. And that was due to just stupidity, too. What? Well, it did the fail music twice just to slow me down more. It's stupid. But of course in the SpongeBob movie game, of course it would be me in a car racing to catch up to you. Because the SpongeBob movie game, as we all know, is literally about nothing other than like driving. And like some platforming, but mostly driving.
So many driving. I wonder how much the movie has driving and all their kind of stuff like that versus the game.
You gotta remember, they lost the car so quickly, dude, that there's, like, barely any. Oh, I remember what caused me problems with this Macho challenge was the stupid oil slick.
Oh, yeah. The ring challenge got me a little bit. I was able to beat it on my first try. Boy, let me tell you a thing. It was...
Oh, I missed the thing to get the chest! Dang it!
Gosh, no, is it... Wait, is it... Oh, never mind. No, it's not.
Also... I'm driving through here. Oh, wait, no, you don't drive through there. What?
Yeah.
I was fairly certain you drove through there to get a treasure chest, but apparently that is not a thing.
Why the heck didn't you watch the freaking chest video by BT Dubs? You should have done that. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, okay. I did that wrong. I gotcha. I figured you out, game. Ow.
You know what? Just fine. Just take all the hits, dude. Just take all the hits. It's fine. No one even cares. Also, I'm pretty sure I should have turned left there. Like, I know where they are. That's not my issue. It's just, like, Okay, I'm just not even playing the game well. Let's just clean slate. You know what? Can we just restart the episode? That'd be great.
Is that a serious thing?
I mean, I'm playing so bad, Chris. Like, honestly, like, it's not even gonna be entertaining.
Don't panic. But I can't, cause the game already saved.
No.
They could just watch my screen. Wow, this guy takes forever to do his sharpshooting skills. I believe in you.
Let me see something real quick. Oh, it's 4 treasure chests, dude?
I didn't know there's 4.
I didn't know there's 4. I thought there was like 2.
Look at his helmet! Oh, you do got his helmet. Okay. That explains a lot. I got you, game. Ooh, I got you, don't you?
Okay, I know where, like, most of these are. There's one that particularly sucks that I know about! No!
Is it a baby? A newborn baby? Those suck a lot.
There's the stupid domino one that's over here that I didn't get.
Hello, dominoes!
Yeah, I gotta restart this again because I need to get all these treasure chests.
Do you want to pause and watch the treasure chest video or something?
I know where they are. Like, okay. I'm as I think about it, I know where they are, so it's not like that. It's just annoying because I'm bad at driving.
Oh, Matt, who gave you your sandwich license?
My sandwich license.
Well, you're driving a sandwich. You don't need a license to drive a sandwich.
Yeah, exactly. I don't have a sandwich license, dude. True. You don't need a license.
True. You should, though. What am I talking
about?
No
wonder the controls are as bad as they are.
Comedy. I like this attack. It's
what? No. No. That is not allowed. What? Okay, that game's just like working against me. I swear.
Wow. That's not very nice of it.
Like, honestly, some cheap shenaniganry is happening to me right now, so.
Shenana Lama Lamigans.
Like, I went under the plankton statue, and it went down, but it, like, pushed me back. So it was like, nope, you didn't get that far. And I'm like, yeah, I did. And the game's like, nope. And I'm like, you're dumb.
Don't call it dumb. That's not very nice. Come on, get angry. Get loud.
I am angry. Feeling mad?
Two steps.
I am angry.
was that a
really
thing?
Mad? It's actually a song, dude. It'll take too long for me to explain where that song is from, so I won't do it.
Is it from SpongeBob? It's from SpongeBob, isn't it? Oh, no, it's from Fairly Odd Parents.
It isn't. It's not from a TV show. It's an internet reference.
I'm a goof goober, yeah!
Oh, that's what opens that. Got it. You have to hit the thing. Oh, okay. I forgot that's how that works, but that's okay.
That's okay. It is okay. I hear you charging your lasers in the background.
Okay.
Is that what you're singing?
Something like that.
What you're singing? That's the reveal for the secret formula.
I love that. That might be like the funniest joke in all of SpongeBob is that they cut the episode short because it's a secret formula and you can't find out.
Yeah, I really do like that. It's like the
okay.
Big
I know I'm. I know I'm only gonna get like 2 treasure chests this time, but you know, whatevs.
Well, they do give you a lot of time to mess around. Well, never mind. They don't really give you a lot of time to mess around. Oh, no, don't.
Oh, no. I know where one of these is. There's one, like, way behind this tractor that I totally forgot about until just now.
There you go. So many angers.
It's, like, way out of the way somewhere out here. I just don't remember where exactly. Oh, it's back here, dude. It's back here.
There we go. Is he going to destroy the floor yet? Oh, there we go. Took forever.
Okay, there's one, and I know where the third one is, and I think I could take a solid guess as to where the fourth one is. So, I think we're good.
I'm a goof, goobs. Well, are you freaking for realsies, olds?
Oh, that wasn't a treasure chest? I swear that was a treasure chest.
Do you swear on your mom, mate?
Okay, well, I beat it, but now I have to do like three other things. How are you doing on that final boss?
I just got to the part where he destroys the floor, so two more hits.
Okay, I gotta watch a cutscene, and then I gotta do three more races. Oh no!
You could do it.
Although, honestly, though, given my, like, general lack of experience with this game compared to Battle for Bikini Bottom, I'm impressed that it was as close as this one as it was the last one.
I mean, stop belittling me!
No, it isn't. I have to wait for the cutscene to end, and I gotta go back!
That's right. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this the safe way, so I don't freaking mess all the things up.
Should I just like? Can I just like not get three more Goofy Goober tokens and two more treasure chests? You know, why do I have to get those anyway?
Well, you need treasure because you're a pirate.
What?
What?
A pirate?
What? Oh, come this. I hate. You're a Goofy Goober, yeah! Dang it.
Kill SpongeBob. Okay, I have to quit. Later. Time challenge. And I don't know where they're last. Do you know? Can you just tell me where the treasure chests are, Chris?
Yeah, of course.
Knock down the statues I got. Way out of the way in the park I got.
For fuck's sake. Okay, the park one. There's one where when you do the final jump,
mm-hmm.
where you break through like a brick, and not the final jump, the jump before the final jump.
Mm-hmm.
If you back up, there's one underneath the tunnel.
Oh, I knew there was one in that area. I just thought it was like not going back. Okay.
Yeah. Oh no, that's death.
And then what's the last one?
Crap! Did you get the one where you take the secret path right before the water?
Yeah, that's the knockdown of statues one.
No, that's a different one.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Thank you very much.
I don't remember where the water part... Okay.
It's like a secret path. Okay, God dang
don't
it!
Don't explain it to me. I'll figure it out. Also, I'm failing this so hard. Oh my god, like I have to restart. This is so bad.
You're a goofy.
Like, honestly, the driving in this game is my worst part of the game. Like, I just... Like, not the worst part of the game and stuff, but it's like the thing I'm worst at this game. If that makes sense. Like,
yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
How many hits do these guys take? Go away! No one likes you! I'm talking to you, man. I'm just kidding. Everybody hates snacks. That's TV show.
Eh.
No, much. Remember, you know the rocking I'm a Goofy Goober thing?
Yeah.
I love
when
that
it's
song.
Like Goofy Goober, and then it actually shows a rock in the movie. You know what I'm talking about?
Or
like when it says Goofy Goober Rock, but like it actually shows a picture of a rock.
That's pretty fantastic. But anyways, I believe I had this song on my first CD ever because I liked it so much.
Oh, you made a CD and put it on there?
I think so. Or my dad made it for me, I should say. But yeah, something like that.
That's awesome. Okay, I'm messing up this driving so bad, but I know the first time challenge isn't too bad, so I'm not too concerned.
It's weird when final bosses have checkpoints.
Yeah, I'm so surprised at that, too.
It's weird, man.
Oh, no, it wasn't the Macho time challenge that bugged me. It was the ring challenge because of the oil stuff. That's what it was.
Yeah, that sounds right. Meow fat. Right! Oh no.
Okay, secret path before the water.
Yeah, it's also right after when there's two boulders.
One boulder.
Or one, yeah.
Two boulder.
Like that.
And then
it's right before the water, there should be a secret path.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah.
Except I died.
Oh Matt. Oh Matty Hugh. That's an organism noise.
It is.
Let's do this, too. Let's just do this. Screw you, butthole.
Are you seriously taking that long on the end thing? Like,
yeah, I'm having issues.
Good, keep having issues. Well, like, maybe for, like, another, like, 20 minutes or so, you know? That'd be great.
No, girl.
At least 10 minutes. Let's go with 10. That's, like, assuming I do the rest of this perfectly, which I won't. But, like, at least 10 minutes, you know?
You said ass.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I'm such a bad driver. Oh no. No.
I don't like how close this laser is to my butt. I don't
Why?
Like it. Wow, Luigi.
Okay, dude, have you seen, there's this video, it's not really a video, but it's just an audio, but it has a picture of Waluigi on it. But there's a thing called Waluigi Funk, and it's just Uptown Funk, but they just throw in random Waluigi noises in the middle of it.
I think that was a thing for a while, wasn't it?
It is actually one of the funniest things I've ever listened to.
I think that was a thing for a little while. People kept, like, replacing music with, like, Waluigi for some reason, and I don't know why.
It's so funny sometimes, though, especially with Uptown Funk. This is, like, because, like, they had some really funny things that were funny.
Well, I have good news and bad news.
The bad news is that I died. Yes.
And the good news is that it started me over at the beginning of the game because I died.
At the beginning of the boss fight?
No, the beginning of the game.
No, it didn't.
No, just, yeah, I totally beat it.
What? You beat the game?
I beat the game, Matt. And now to thank the brave heroes. Cause I am the champion.
You know what, Chris? You know what, Chris?
What?
I'm thinking of a thing. You got 20 questions.
What? I can't. Is it a SpongeBob?
No.
Dang it. Is it a thing?
Yes. Sort of.
I guess anything's a thing, isn't it? Is it alive?
No.
Is it SpongeBob related?
Kind of, but not really.
Oh, come on. Can I find it around my house?
No. Although, honestly, like, you might sometime in the near future.
What? Is it related to, like, winter or something?
No, not at all.
Okay, well, I was like, you never know. Can I find it outside?
Yes, technically speaking.
Can I buy it in the store?
No. Hint, it's not an actual object.
Is it the ocean?
No. Second hint, it's not something you could touch or feel physically. It is more of a metaphysical. It's a metaphysical thing.
Is it my victory?
No.
Is it the next race?
No.
Dang it. How many questions am I asked?
I don't know. Do you want the answer?
Sure.
It is my amount of rage right now. But good job, Chris. You did it.
You do sound like
so now we're tied, which is awesome.
Yeah.
I'm gonna keep going because I'm ring challenging it. I think I can get to the final boss. But hey, stuff. I have a question actually. You know how in like Battle for Bikini Bottom when you 100% you get like bonus cutscene? Is there like any bonus cutscene in this game?
Yup. You're a goofy goober. Yeah. There's like a music video for it.
Is that because I think I remember seeing that? So that's why I'm like, Oh my goodness. Was it your Let's Play that I saw it, or is it just because like the game counts 100% minus the extras? The extras don't count towards 100%. So I'm wondering whether you need to get all the extras in order to view it or not.
Yeah, I think so. Nice. You know what? I could look that up right now.
I'm just curious. I was just thinking about that, actually.
Do you have to get all the treasure chests to see the bonus cutscene? SpongeBob.
You don't even need to say movie.
Game. No, I think that's specific enough. Or not. Or not.
But I got all the treasure chests before you beat the game. No, actually, you beat the game just as I was about to get the last one. So never mind.
I don't know. 100 movie video.
No. Got it. Got it. Okay, now it's for the worst part of the ring challenge right here. If I beat this, then I'm good. I'm gonna beat you at the race, Chris. I'm gonna beat you at the race.
The race of me watching the credits.
I'm gonna beat you first. I'm gonna beat you at the game. You haven't actually beaten the game yet, so like, I'm gonna race you. And I'm gonna win. Chris, you don't understand. This is a matter of life or death, and I am winning right now. I'm beating you at the race right now.
What the heck is this thing?
What thing?
Okay, I just saw, like, Hero Pants. Is that one of the bad ones? Do you play that?
SpongeBob Hero Pants? Yeah. The bad one. That isn't the one I played, but that's, like, the bad one that just came out recently.
Oh, is it?
The bad one that I played is Atlantis SquarePants, which, don't play it.
Yeah. Okay.
You can play it on, like, GBA and DS, and it's, like, okay, but, like, that's still, like, bad.
I just see a video with, like, a thumbnail of an angry giant Squidward that, like, he has his upper body, and then the rest of his body is, like, it's, like, a mountain or something. It's really weird, kind of terrifying.
It might be, there was a SpongeBob game, Plankton's Robotic Revenge, that came out.
Oh, yeah, it's Hero Pants, it says right here.
Yeah, it was a co-op game that was made, and it was supposed to like revamp the SpongeBob gaming thing, but it didn't really work. Because like it was okay, but it's like nothing special.
Plain Sponge.
I am like hacking this ring challenge. There's no way I should be doing as well as I am right now, but just for some reason it just is.
Cause now you don't have any stress on you, so you're just free.
I'm free. So what did you think of the race, Chris? What do you think? How was it?
Well,
it was fun. I had fun.
Yeah, it was fun. My voice is going all scratchy for some reason. I do enjoy the other Battle for Bikini Bottom much more. Oh, I don't get much points.
What, the race, race or the game? Or both?
I guess both, really. But yeah, this one was pretty good too. There's no real complaints. We had a lot less technical difficulties.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
A lot less.
I feel like this one was a lot more chill than the first one. Because like the first one, we didn't actually know what we were doing. Where like this one, we're like, we've done this before. We can do it better now. So it was much more relaxed. Like we had more games and stuff that happened, which is cool. Although I think like just because of like all the racing and stuff, it kind of was like harder to make it like as good, you know what I mean? With Battle for Bikini Bottom, it's like all pretty much almost exclusively platforming. So it's like that's the good part of the game, where like in this game there's so much more gimmicky stuff that makes it harder, you know? But it was fun.
My game is frozen on a loading screen now. So that's unfortunate.
I don't think that counts as beating the game, Chris. I think you have to, like, refight the final boss.
I do. Yeah, I knew this was going to freaking happen, too, but I'm really happy it didn't happen when, you know, the race was still happening.
No, the race still is happening, Chris. The race is always happening.
It's always happening.
Okay. Can I beat the Macho Challenge? Because, honestly, I think I'm better at this final boss than the Battle for Bikini Bottom one, so I was going to, like, at least show that off that I'm, like, pretty good at it.
Okay, well, maybe it'll eventually load for some reason.
That'd be cool. But, congratulations, Chris. You're better than me at the movie game. You're better at sliding and driving than I am.
Yay! It means I'm a better person.
You should take on, like, a taxi job, dude. Because, like, you're better at driving and stuff than I am. So, like, that would be a pretty solid job for you.
Yeah. Taxi.
It's the right one. Okay, you're cool.
I'll call it the unoriginal taxi.
The unoriginal taxi. It's just another taxi. But it has an original in front of it. That's kind of like a paradox though, because like the fact that it's called the unoriginal taxi makes it original. Oh no, exactly. No, I'm gonna lose just because of that, I swear. I like half glitched hit the wall. And I swear I'm gonna like lose this because of that one thing.
You're gonna lose what?
The race, the not the race, but like the time challenge. 22, 23, 24, 25. Oh my god. Oh my god. You have no idea what I'm all the feels right now. 30, 32, 33, 34. No! No! I was right to
put it. Did you lose, Matt?
I was right at the finish line and it said challenge failed.
I was in the finish line and it said it failed. See, that happened to me too. Also. Oh, come on. Okay, well, I'm gonna stop recording for a second here.
What?
Okay.
So, well, right now is the part where there is technical difficulties. So, are you recording now again?
Well, I'm recording my audio. I shouldn't have stopped that to begin with.
You have so many problems today, Chris. I think that should cost you the race.
I'm actually kind of surprised I won the race. I thought that wasn't going to happen. Okay, now my Wii is just broken.
Okay, then, well, how about this, then? I'm going to try and beat this, but in the meantime, once again, vote for the next race. There's another one, because you have to figure out who's actually better at SpongeBob games, Chris or myself. So, either it's going to be Creature from the Krusty Krab, which, Chris is currently Let's Playing. You should check that out, bro. Brozif Magosif, or Broet Maget. I don't know what Chris is doing right now, but you know. Okay, you should...
Matt, help me, I'm stuck! I fell! I can't get up!
If you don't watch his Creature from the Krusty Krab Let's Play, he'll permanently be stuck over there, so you better watch that Let's Play, bro. And also, I died again.
Oh god, there's a crocodile in my house!
and then also.
Those are crocodile noises, help!
What's your. You. Are you okay? He's not okay. So, watch this Creature from the Krusty Krab Let's Play. You know, it's pretty decent. He's, like, as of the time of this recording, he beat the game. I don't know when it'll be posted, whether the Let's Play will be done, because honestly, I kind of forget how long that game is. I'm pretty sure it's shorter than the... It's shorter than these two games, definitely. But I don't remember how long it is exactly.
It's, like, 19 parts long, so it'll be over in, like... math. It's like 3 weeks,
A Creature from the Krusty Krab is one. We probably wouldn't do that one 100% just because the 100% is so finicky, and if you miss a thing, then you're basically screwed. Like, there's no way to go back and get it unless you replay the whole episode, which is kind of dumb for completionists, but you know, it is what it is. So if you want to do Creature from the Krusty Krab, that's cool. We could do that. But then there's also Revenge of the Flying Dutchman, a game that I probably like less than Creature from Krusty Krab, and Chris hasn't played yet. But you know, if you want us to race that, he'll probably have played the game by the time we get around to doing that. And I have to replay the game because I've only played that game once, and I am not well equipped to race a game after not playing it for about 6 years. So now it'll might take a bit longer for that one to come out. But hey, if you think that'll produce a better result, then go ahead and say we should do that, and then we will make our decision partially influenced by your votes, if not fully.
Also, super important, down down up down up, there we go.
Oh, you're recording the game again?
Yeah,
cool.
I'm gonna go check out the thing I was trying to check out last
which
time.
Is
when you very slowly go off the Knucklehead McSpadgetron, like where the last jump is, you could actually explore that area.
Oh, really?
I don't know why, but it's a thing. So it's really weird you end the game on 68 goober tokens. I don't know
it's
why.
69, not 68. 69. It's just that one of yours didn't count randomly, remember?
Oh. It did count, but it just didn't show up in my menu. Like, it was on my counter. I think my final boss token isn't colored in.
Oh, that's why. Because your game froze, dude. That's why.
It saved, though.
Failed again? I'm sorry. This is nonsense right now. This is nonsense. I'm passing the finish line like right on 35, but it's like just barely not quick enough. I'm sorry, we can't. I don't even need to beat the final boss. I just need to beat this for my own like sanity. So what else? Yeah, watch his Let's Play. Vote for which game we should race to tiebreak. Personally, honestly, like, I haven't played either game in so long that like it's honestly. Like, Chris probably will have the advantage, but I'll probably replay the game fully, regardless of which game, so we'll see how it goes. Yeah. I've played Creature from the Krusty Krab, I think, twice, Revenge of the Flying Dutchman I've only done once, mostly because I didn't really like it. But that doesn't mean that I can't race it, and honestly, both the games aren't nearly as good as these two, so that's a thing. But if there's one That's game I would suggest, if there's a few games you can't suggest, and honestly just choose those two, but like, don't suggest SpongeBob the Yellow Avenger on DS, because that is literally like bad, like, no, don't do that, because it's literally everything you hate about RPGs, like the go and get me this thing, and that's the entire game, that's literally all the game is, so like, don't do that, because that'll be like, Laundry List the Race, and I don't like Laundry List the Race. It's not a really good race, honestly. So let's not do that. In addition, don't do Atlantis SquarePants, because I will actually punch you in the face.
Don't do it. He's done it to me multiple times.
I know where all of you live. Don't do it. Don't do it. Just don't, because I will be very deeply upset with you. So that's a thing that you should be wary of. But also on another thought, the other thought being, I have a channel, if you didn't know that. As of the time this is posted, there may be something on there may not. As of the time of this recording, I'm currently undergoing a bit of a channel reboot, because I'm going to be focusing a bit more on, like, game design stuff, which is pretty cool, right? Like, game design's pretty awesome. So, if you're interested in game design or anything like that, then be sure to go and check it out. Chris will probably neglect to put the link in the description, but that's okay.
Hey, I
just
do
search
it most
MML's
of time.
Commentaries on the YouTube search bar. You'll find it there, or go to youtube.com/MML129. I don't like advertising that one as much because it's like the numbers are dumb. Also, finally beat it by literally 1 second. What? What? No. Are you serious? It said I failed. I said it failed because I didn't land on the ground in time.
You landed on the ground.
Okay, I hate this. I hate this challenge right now. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it.
So am I just going to be told to beat my best time again?
I hate this. This is the worst. This is the worst. This is actually the worst. Chris, how did you beat this on your first try? This is so dumb. You said you beat it by 1 second,
magic.
but did it count? When you say 1 second, is that like when you crossed the finish line, or is that like when you landed on the ground afterwards? Because for me,
when I landed on the ground.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I don't get it. Like, they should count it when you cross the finish line, because it's like the finish line.
Yup.
This game.
What the balls? All the time challenges after you beat it for the first time turn into your best.
Oh yeah, the ring
challenge
does too.
It's stupid.
You can never do the ring challenges ever again.
This game is so stupidly broken. That's dumb.
But yeah, so I have a thing too. The main reason why you should actually come to my channel, though, whether I've rebooted or not, is Chris is in another race that's going on, and probably sometime in the near future we're going to be recording more of that. And I haven't updated it that much because of the fact that I was trying to get this reboot underway. Either way, it's of Super Mario 3D World, not Land, World. I know that Chris may have confused you with the names of those games, but you know, Super Mario 3D World is a game. We're racing it, and that's fun. And it's me, Chris, and then Grand Crystal Star, who is a Let's Player you may or may not know, and Ring-Tailed Randall, formerly known as Ringtail Randall, who you may or may not know. He was, Chris and I were both at one point in charge of running a Let's Play community channel known as the Faction of Players, and Ringtail Randall actually played a huge part in that as well at a different point in time. So that's the best connection I can establish, other than he's a friend of mine and now a friend of Chris's. You also actually saw me and Randy in Unoriginal Craft for a while, but Randy and I both left. Me more because of time obligations, and Randy more because of personal obligations.
I was wondering which way you're going to go with that.
So either way, it's going to be a fun time. Super Mario 3D World Race. More parts coming soon, and it'll be great.
I'm a floating sponge.
Okay. So yeah.
First of all, I don't respect that you're advertising all these things on my channel. I don't agree with any of them. That's all I got. Okay, well, I think this video's gone
I'm
gonna
long try and beat
that.
This one more time. If I don't, then that's it. We're done. We're done. Like, I give up. But, like, I'm at a point in my life where I need to accomplish something.
What the heck?
I need to accomplish something. That means stuff. I don't know. I'm out of commentary. I'm actually, like, out of commentary.
I think that's a good sign.
Yeah, we got, like, 20 seconds, okay? 20, 25 seconds.
Oh,
now
okay,
20 seconds. If I don't beat the race in then I'll be very angry. But, you know, whatevs, you know? Whatevs. No, it's just a video game. When it comes down to it, it's just a video game. I'm going to keep saying that to myself over and over again. Because this has been particularly frustrating.
Wow, you're horrible at this.
Nope, it failed me again. Okay, you know what? I hate this game now. Whoa. Screw this game. This game's the worst. I'm done. Done.
I'm a simple sponge. He's gone. Alright, everybody. I'm not Simple Patrick. Oh, he literally left the room, everybody. What a stupid poop head, am I right? Am I right? High fives. High fives all around. Yay! I'm still going though. Bye, everybody!